Everybody, so it's like been a while. I don't even remember when my last video was. It was like 2 weeks before school started. So first off, new location and filming. We're on this beautiful wall of magic, which is where I'm gonna start recording now. Once I get a camera and a better setup, I'll be able to show you all of it. And there's a Phantom of the Opera mask. Woo! Yeah. Awesome. And an amazing painting that my friend drew for me that's like anti-cutting and self-harm, and I love this hall. I could just drape it. And yes, that is not a Les poster, but the, like, dust cover to the DVD, because I don't have a Les poster. Why is something Les up there? Anyway, so if you read the title of today's video, you know that today is a school rant! And I'm ranting about school, because I am legally bound to go to school from the ages of 5 to 16. Yep. So, yeah, been in school a while, and I know what I like and don't like about it. And so, yeah, I'm just going to take you through the four periods I have each day and tell you what I fucking hate about each and every one of them. So, let's start on this rantful journey, and woo! Alright, so first period of the day I have is health/gym, and I don't really have a problem with that class. You know, it is what it is. I'd rather take it now and get it over with, because I only have to have one health credit to graduate from high school. So let's do it now and get it the fuck over with, so I don't have to do it again, ever. Ever. And there's not much wrong with that class. I enjoy that class. I have some awesome peeps in that class. I make jokes in that class. My teacher's pretty cool. It's a pretty easy class. The one thing I don't like about that class is we have a very small locker room, so sound is easily heard. Even if you're whispering, I can understand what the fuck you're saying, and I am half deaf in my left ear. So, yeah, this is a small-ass locker room, maybe the size of my room, and my room has my bed, my dresser, a little path from my doorway in between my dresser and my bed, and just a little path to my closet, which I never use, because fuck that. I just throw my clothes on the floor, it's so much easier to find them. I know my mom hates it. But, so yeah, this locker room isn't that big, and people play music, and it's not like everybody's playing their music at the same time, which would be horrendous, and I'd punch everybody in the face. But there are these one group of girls who I don't like just in general. I went to school with, like, a few of them, and I don't like them. I'm not a fan of them, but I don't, like, go up to their faces and call them bitches and cunts, no matter how much I fucking want to. And I'm sorry, I'm fixing my bangs. This is really rude. And they play their fucking music every goddamn day once we're getting dressed back into our clothes. Now, we get to the locker rooms, like, the bell, because I have first period gym, like I said. We get to the bell, we get in the locker rooms before the bell, and we have, like, 15 minutes to change out. We get, like, 5 minutes to change back into our clothes. And so I don't want to listen to your shit-ass music when I'm trying to fucking pull my fucking pants on, because skinny jeans are hard as fuck to put on when you're sweaty, slash wet, slash just gotten out of the shower, slash what the fuck ever. And I don't want to listen to your shit-ass Lil Wayne and fucking Taylor Swift and all this other nasty-ass bullshit. Like, I don't want to fucking listen to that. I swear I'm going to start fucking blasting AC/DC and see how they like it. And no one tells these girls to shut their fucking phones off. It's fucking ridiculous. And they don't even have good music taste. Like, I'll respect your music taste, even if I don't like it. But when it's to the point where some girl was listening to Hey Jude by the Beatles, I'm like, I like the Beatles. She's just like, the Beatles fucking suck. They're old and gross, and they're the worst band ever. This is One Direction. Like, bitch, fucking please. Like, oh my god. I'm just gonna, hey, come here. Bam! Right across your fucking face, because I can't. And, ugh. Anyway, so second period, which is, oh, look at my nails. Oh god, they're so gross. This hand's Oh, hey there. What you doing there? What you doing there, computer? You trying to log me off? I don't appreciate that. Yeah, this hand's all pretty. This hand's all pretty, but this hand is, like, gross. And I'll take it for being a girl. Anyway, my second period of the day is English 1, and I really like that class, and I really like my teacher. We have some pretty good discussions and things like that in that class, but everybody else I fucking hate, because they're all dumb. We had our midterm this week, and literally, like, only 8 people passed, and I was one of those people. I got the highest fucking grade in the class, which was a 97, which is a pretty high grade, but fucking still. It's English 1. It was, you read 3 stories, and then answer 9 multiple choice questions about each story, and then you write, like, a short response. How is that fucking hard? Ugh, I couldn't. And, like, so right now we're doing Raisin in the Sun, and then we're gonna do, Romeo and Juliet, and literally no one can fucking read, and it's fucking ridiculous. Like, this is literally how they read. They're like, alright, I'm taken from Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. This is how they fucking read. Alright, let me find a part. They explained what had what's that word? That word. And as the like, that's how they fucking read. I'm like, how did you get to fucking high school? Wow, that was an intense high school. How the fuck did you get to high school reading like a fucking idiot? I can't. And these people are reading, and they can't read with any emotion in their voice. They can't read, like, they just can't fucking read out loud. And now I understand why there are 11 fucking people failing English fucking 1. This isn't like some AP American literature class. This is English 1. 1. Oh my fucking god. I can't fucking even. And oh my god. I can't. I'm unable to even do so. Anyway, period number 3, aka my third class of the day, which is Honors World History, which is a pretty fun class. We have great discussions in that class, and I have a great teacher and some great fellow peers in that class, but everybody else is fucking ignorant and a fucking asshole. And, alright, let me just take an example from today. We were sitting there, and so, if you guys know, I am not a straight person, I am fucking omnisexual, and I support everybody in the LGBTQ community, meaning gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgendered, cisgendered, gender fluid, gender neutral, gender queer, questioning, everything in the gender and sexuality spectrum. I support them and I love them for who they are, and they need to stand up for themselves and be who they are. And fucking everybody, like 80% of this class is fucking homophobic and fucking prejudiced and fucking intolerant, and I can't. And the kid I fucking sit next to has called me a faggot ass cunt to my face. Like, I'm unable to even, I can't do this class. Like, literally, I can't fucking deal with this class, which is sad, because I thoroughly enjoy the subject. I fucking love history. I want to do something with history in my career, because it's so fucking amazing. I love it. And literally, these kids make me not want to go to class because I hate being called a faggot and a homo, and that I'm gonna burn in hell, and that God hates me, and that I'm a Satanist. And I don't enjoy this because, you know what? Fuck you! I'm agnostic, and I'm proud. And so, you know, I don't give two fucking dick shakes whether you like me or not. But don't fucking insult my community, because then I'll fucking punch you in the face. I can't fucking deal with these goddamn people in this goddamn class. Like, I can deal with most of them. I have some pretty cool friends in there, like Molly and Angel and Farrah and Brielle and Juliana. They're pretty cool fucking people, and I thoroughly enjoy them. And another girl whose name I can't remember at this point, but they're all pretty nice to me, and Gabby, and they're just nice to me, and they stick up with me, even though I'm a smart ass and a fucking know-it-all in that class. They deal with me, and they don't call me a faggot-ass cunt, which is fucking ridiculous, and I can't even, like, really? Really? What the fuck? And as I said, let's take an example from today. We were doing, because my teacher is a former politician. She worked in D.C., she worked in the Senate, and she worked with representatives from my state, and worked in campaigning, and things like that. And so we were doing the thing where you fall on the spectrum if you're conservative, or libertarian, or liberal, or statist. And so there was, like, a personal thing, and then, like, an economic thing. You had to, like, circle A, like, M or D for it. Agree, maybe, or disagree. And so she had to explain what, like, allowing, like, sex between two consenting adults. And she's all like, basically, it's like you either agree with letting people do what they want in the comfort of their own homes and their own privacy, and it doesn't matter as long as they're saying yes, or you don't. And so some guy was just like, what's that mean? And she's like, it means like everyone can have sex with whoever they want. And he's just like, does that mean gay people can have sex? And she's just like, yeah. And he goes, LOL, fuck that, and circles G. And then he looks at me, he's just like, you better only have sex with boys or I'm going to beat you up. I'm like, seriously? You fucking can't. I fucking can't. I'm unable to fucking even. And that's not my only problem with this class. This is a 12-minute fucking video, and this is basically just me ranting about stupid fucking assholes. And the other problem I have with this class is everybody's so, like, not tolerant of smartness. I should say, I am a smart person. I have A's in all my classes, which really isn't anything. I'm a very intelligent person. I'm very, very self-aware and knowledgeable and aware of the things that are going on in my world. And so every day we do a current event, and I always have like 10 fucking current events. And also we do, like, we have discussions in class about things like controversial things like abortion and rape standards and equal marriage and things like that. And, you know, when we're just discussing things in general, like a while ago we were discussing Marie Antoinette and things like that, and I'm fucking sitting there and someone was just like, is Marie Antoinette the one who said let them eat cake? I'm like, yeah, she's that lady that you're thinking of, but she didn't say let them eat cake. That's actually a common misquotation. And some girl sitting across me goes, you're just a fucking know-it-all. I'm like, really, bitch? I'm trying to correct people on things that are correct and make sure you don't go spewing ignorant wrong shit to everybody. So what the fuck? I can't even. If you see me smiling a lot and laughing as I rant about this, it's because I'm able to even, and literally this stupidity and ignorance just fucking blows my mind. Like, how are you this fucking dumb? Oh my god. Let me just take a sip of water and calm down. You know, before I started this, I was really cold, but now I'm all angry and fucking pent up and ranty, and, yeah, anyway, like, seriously, I couldn't give two shakes of a dick like, if you wanted to listen to me or not, but go ahead, not listen to me. Go ahead and fucking misquote Copernicus and Voltaire and Marie Antoinette. Go ahead and spew the wrong shit about the Aztecs and the Mayans and the fucking Incas. Go ahead and say that Christopher Columbus was the first person who proved that the world was round. Go ahead and say that, was it Aristotle? Aristotle. That Aristotle was right about humans only having 5 sentences. Go ahead and look like a retard to everybody else in the world while I sit here and I'm actually knowledgeable and laugh at you when I fucking pass you on the street to my goddamn good paying job and you're sitting there because in your interview for some bullshit job you said some bullshit thing that's not really true and they decided to hire the next guy. So have fun, you fucking dick bitch. Anyway, moving on to my fourth period of the day, which is also a period I can get very ranty about. This is my choir class, but this isn't an actual choir class. You know what this is? This is an intro to music class. Intro to music. I didn't sign up for an intro to fucking music class. You know what I signed up for? A chorus class. One sec. Let me just go and get something. Anyway, so let me just show you this fucking bullshit. Alright, so this is the little folder that I got when I was signing up for classes last year in 8th grade. This is the consent form that I have that these are the courses I'm going to be taking. This is the thing that I signed up the original classes for when I got this sheet and before we did it online. That's some bullshit sheet. I don't know why that's in there. So, originally, on the little sheet, and course selections change. Because, you know, that's fucking life. And so, listen to this fucking bullshit. That is not my transcript. Where is mine? Hello? Transcript, where you at? Anyway, I can just do this without it. That's it. This is it. Alright. This is 9th grade course selections for Wakefield High School, 2013 to 2014 school year. Elective courses. Visual and Performing Arts. Vocal Music. Beginning Vocal Music 1. Fall. You know what it has on my little thing right here that I signed up with? You know what I put? You know what I put? You know what I put? Asked under my drawing class and under my German 1 class, which is a class I didn't get, and they put me in some fucking business and finance class, which I didn't sign up for, which is nowhere on this. Nowhere, and I understand that classes change, and, like, you can't fit people in other classes, but I had literally 4 other ones, and you couldn't give me one that I fucking wanted. Anyway, that's a different issue, and that's for another day. Vocal Music 1, Mixed Choir. You know what it says on here? Vocal Music 1, Mixed Choir. Then why the fuck am I in a fucking intro to music class for people who have never taken a goddamn chorus class in their life? Last year, I was in intermediate women's choir. The year before, I was in beginning women's choir. The year before, I was in a community choir. The year before that, I was in choir. The year before that, I was in choir. The year before that, I was in choir. And also here's a certification, here's a certificate of award. Do you know what this award is for? It says, this certificate is awarded to Jamie, I'm gonna blank out my name right there. This is to certify that this student has been awarded the honor of most improved chorus member. Not only was I in chorus, but I improved, and I won a fucking award for it. I even got a fucking medal. So, why the fuck, and I just So why the fuck am I in an intro to music class? This class is literally for people who have never taken a singing lesson, who don't know how to read sheet music, who don't know what the notes are, who don't know what the scale is, who don't know what major scales and grand scales are, who don't know how to breathe correctly, who don't know how to create correct vowels, who don't know dictation rules, who don't know how to fucking stand properly, who don't know concert etiquette, when I know all this fucking stuff. So why the fuck am I in this class? And this class isn't even like a choir class, you know, like if you're in a beginning choir class, you're gonna like run over like how to read music and the notes and solfege and things like that really quickly, and then you're gonna hop into learning music as a fucking choir. And this is no choir class. This, like I said, an intro to music class where you work solo. And that is not fucking cool. I don't want to work solo because I'm not good with solo. You know how big my choir class last year was? 13, 14 people. You know how big my class is this year? 42 people! I have fucking social anxiety, and you want me to sing in front of 42 people, half of which are super fucking judgmental and use the term faggot all the time and don't like gay people. But these judgmental people are the ones who don't want to sing in front of the class. Like, fuck you and your fucking ass with a big black fucking dildo and no goddamn lube. So fuck your life. And we're not even learning songs in my range. And it just makes me so angry. Anyway, calming down. I love my school. It's really great. We have some great after-school programs, great clubs, great teachers. But yeah. Alright, guys. So that was my angry school rant. And this is a 20-minute long video. I'm going to have to edit this. And it's going to be long. But yeah. I hope you enjoyed. And I'll be getting a new webcam soon. And I promise, new video camera. Soon I can start videos again. And next video won't be so as ranty. So yeah, peace out, guys. Mwah. Oh, and links to my main channel, Tumblr and Twitter in the doobly doo below. I'm gonna start trying to be on Twitter more. So yeah, I love all of you and I will see you later.